Hello folks, welcome back to another video, and in today's video I'm going to show you how you can host your public Notion page on a custom domain. So without wasting time, let's get started. So what I'm talking about, so if you have shared a Notion page, you might know what a URL might look like. It might be your username .notion.site and the database ID. Well, it doesn't look like professional. It works but doesn't look professional. Well, what's a better way to do it? Why not host it on a custom domain? Now, how will it look like? Well, I hosted my own page on a custom domain known as bigeng.ml. As you can see, the two pages are exactly identical, but one of them is hosted on Notion and one of them is hosted on a custom domain. So this is what we're going to do today, and let's get straight into this video. So obviously you need a domain. So if you have a domain, you can just skip a few minutes ahead. Now if you want a domain for free, you can just check out my freemium video where you can get a domain for free. So just check it out. Now once you do that, you need a Cloudflare account. You can easily create a Cloudflare account. It's a free account. Doesn't worry, doesn't ask for credit card details or stuff like that. Once you do that, you can click on add a site. And now add the domain you own. So host Notion is the domain I currently own and I'm going to test it on. So yeah, let's do that. And it's going to check for these different names and stuff like that. Obviously, as I said, these are paid plans, but you can have to choose the free plan if you want to choose it for free. If you want other complications and stuff like that, if you know about what you are doing, then you can go for these paid plans. But free plans gets the job done. So we are going to do just that. Now checking for the existing DNS record. So it might take some time depending upon your the register and where you bought your domain from, if it's a clean domain or stuff like that. So yeah, since it's a clean domain, nothing has been added here. It's obviously not going to find any DNS records. So just continue. Okay, so confirm. And now you need to copy these name servers and paste it in your domain register. So you can just do that. I'm just going to paste them right here and click change name servers. Alright, just let me check again if the name servers have been changed. Okay, so it have been changed. Now let's click continue, done, and check name servers. You can skip these recommendations. Now it is obviously going to check. Now, but by the time it does that, what you need to do is you need to go and check for workers. You can click here and just go for click on workers. Now click create a worker. Now just leave it right here and now visit freeutonsite.com. This is the magic part where it all begins. This is the main thing we are going to use. So yeah, obviously paste the domain you want to host it on. So host notion.ml and the public page of the Notion. So yeah, just search for the Notion and the public page you want to share and host your public domain on. So I obviously created a dummy page here. So I'm just going to click share, click open share to web and copy this particular link and paste it here. Now what does this add a pretty link really mean? So I'm going to show it to you right now here as well. So if I go on bigeng.ml/jobs, it is going to be redirect to a particular page which is also public but has a pretty URL, as you can see, jobs. Now if it wasn't for this particular pretty URL, as you can as you saw, there was a big database ID. So if you don't do that, it might look like ugly that. So if you want to add a pretty URL, you can do the same. So I'm just going to add pretty URL and the slug is going to be test. And the page for that particular slug is going to be this particular page which we created inside it. So just copy that particular page and paste it right here. Now you can also add your, these are the meta tags, but it doesn't really make sense because you know Notion overrides them. So it doesn't really make sense. Though you can add your custom script. So example, it says Google Analytics. So if you want your Google Analytics or Mixpanel Analytics and stuff like that, you can obviously add those particular things here. Just paste the entire script and paste it right over here. I don't want to do that just for this demo. So it's done. Now click copy code and select, go back to this particular page. Select all of it, pressing the Ctrl A and press Ctrl V to paste it right over here. Now click save and deploy. It's going to deploy. Remember this name, dry shape. You can obviously change it, but I won't. Okay, so it's deployed. Now don't go do this particular page just yet. Just wait and follow these steps. And just visit host Notion again and click on workers here. Now click add route. And as you can see, asterisk.hostnotion.ml/asterisk. Now what does it really mean? Now we need to check that again, but what does this asterisk mean? So if you don't add asterisk, www.hostnotion.ml might not be accessible because there was no wildcard entry, that particular thing. So we need to add asterisk there. Now after slash asterisk, well, if you add slash jobs or any pretty URL we added there, we want it to recognize it. So we will create our template on that particular basis. So asterisk dot host notion.ml/*. I will paste this particular template in the description, so go check it out and select the worker. So worker was dry shape, obviously. Let's click save. Okay, it's done now. Now what we need to do is we need to visit our DNS here and click on add a record. Now the type of record is going to be 4A. Now 4 and single A, 4A stands for IPv6 and single A stands for IPv4. Doesn't really matter if you are not technical. So just type @ here and 100 and 2:. Now remember, it should be proxied here. If it isn't proxied, that might be some errors. So yeah, just add that. And since you also want it to be accessible via www, we'll do that as well. So I'll just do that. So www, and then don't add .hostnotion.ml, it might not work. You just add www, it will take care of the rest. Again, same 100, 2:, and click save. Okay, now it's almost done. Now one another thing to make sure is if you go to SSL/TLS, make sure that it's on flexible and not full, because if it's on full, it might not work. So that is taken care of. And also make sure to turn on this SSL/TLS recommender. So just do that. And yeah, now let's check if it's the name servers are changed. Okay, so verifying, maybe we can check it here. Change name servers again. Till the time it does that, we can also do thing is we can create rules. So let's say that person visits www.hostnotion.ml, and if there is no rule, it might be state that particular page. So there might be two URLs which might be accessible, www.hostnotion.ml and hostnotion.ml. We only want it to be stay on one page and redirect the other request to that particular main page. To do that, we can create a rule here. And example is, let's say that example should be www.hostnotion.ml, and pick a settings, we need to redirect it forwarding URL, and select status code is permanent redirect and hostnotion.ml. So yeah, let's just click save as draft. If there is another thing to make sure is that I forgot to add asterisk, because if you know www.hostnotion.ml/test and we don't add asterisk, it might not work. So yeah, just we are going to do that. And okay, and another thing I forgot is, I guess there was something, I'll just leave it right here. There is something I forgot, I'll just get back to it. Okay, so yeah. Yes, this is something I forgot. Okay, yeah, so the rule has been created. And let's just go to overview and check whether it's working or not. So yeah, it's taking some time to, you know, verify those name servers. Maybe we'll get back. I'll just cut it right here and see on the other side.
A few moments later.
All right, so it's done. It's being recognized, as you can see. Great news, Cloudflare is protecting your service, and then we can also make sure that our rules are working. So yeah, and let's just make sure that our workers are redirected to perfect path as well. All right, so it's all done. Now the moment of truth. Now we are going to visit hostnotion.ml. Okay, so I guess you see it's all seeming right. Now let's just wait and hope for the best. Alrighty, so it's working great. Come on, now let's test our page rule as well. So www. Alright, okay, so it's redirecting as well. It's great. Now let's just test our pretty URL test and let's see if that's working. Alright, so it's all working, and as you can see, the page is completely similar to what we currently have here. So this is the particular page. I'll just click copy this particular link and paste it here. Alright. So as you can see, as I said, told you that these two are identical pages. One of them is hosted on custom domain and one of them is hosted on Notion. So it's really great. You can add your custom tags, you can add your custom scripts and stuff like that. And best of all, it's free. It's really great and it all works. Now one thing to make sure, this while adding workers, I need to make sure that if you're adding for www and stuff like that, it needs to be styled with asterisk. So asterisk hostnotion.ml/asterisk. If you do not do that, it might show you some host error or Cloudflare error. So this is the exact thing you need to make sure. I'll link this template down below in the description. So just follow this exact template. All right. So don't make any mistakes there. And I guess that's it. That's the way to do it. You can add your custom things, stuff like that. And yeah, these workers are good enough for 1 lakh requests per day. So if you're not getting not more than that particular thing, you're fine. It's free. Now, one other thing I forgot to tell you is that this is because we are hosting it on Notion, and you know, Notion always keeps evolving and stuff like that. So there might be at moments that if you visit that particular page, it might be working previously, but now it's not. What you need to do is you just visit this particular GitHub page and create issues here. You can talk about how your page is not working, or you know, scripts are not working and stuff like that. So this community is pretty active. As you can see, there are more than 100 folks and more than 700 stars. So community is pretty active. They keep evolving, helping each other and stuff like that. So yeah, just I'll add this particular link in the description. So just go check it out. And if you are facing any other issues, I might be also able to help. So if you have any issues, you can just join our Discord server and we can discuss there, or you can comment down below as well. And I guess that's it for this particular video, folks. Hope you like it. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below. And thanks for watching.